The way how perspective works in Hitman Absolution is pretty unique. I don't know if you have noticed it, but in most to nearly every case, 47's weapons aren't clipping through the walls even if you're standing right in front of them. That is interesting because the distance between 47 and the wall he's looking at is too short for his arm and his weapon to fit in perfectly. So at least his weapon should clip through the wall while aiming at it. Somehow it still looks like there will be enough space for a whole person to fit in between 47 and the wall. And I always wondered how the developers solved this kind of problem on which so many third-person game developers failed. Okay, maybe failed sounds a bit harsh, it's not like that this little error is so extremely unacceptable, it is just a very common kind of bug that destroys the illusion. Anyway, I just wanted to talk about how Hitman Absolution solved this whole weapon and arm clipping through the wall thing. And I must say, it was kind of hard to get to the answer of the question. But before I can explain how they solved it, I must explain a bug in the game that I never was able to explain to myself. Some certain NPCs use cell phones. Thank you for your attention. These cell phones are some kind of special prop because they seem to be attached to the behavior and status of their owners, which you can find out if you kill someone who is using a cell phone. For example, strangling someone who is having a call results in a cell phone dropping next to the victim, but if it dies, the cell phone just disappears. It gets even weirder if you shoot someone who is using their cell phone because now it is stuck in the air. Now back to the topic of perspective. When you now walk to the flying cell phone, it all seems normal, but when aiming on it, you might notice a change? This change I'm talking about is not about the changed size of the cell phone, because walking a bit further from it shows that it is not the cell phone that got bigger, it is 47 who became smaller. The interesting part here is that the common 47 and the aiming 47 seem to be two different models. The common 47 is as common as one can think. He moves normal, his perspective is normal, and the camera angle works as it should work. But when aiming, there is a transition where the model of 47 is glued on the camera. What I mean with that is that 47's aiming model isn't really three-dimensional, it just pretends to be three-dimensional. The aiming 47 is on another layer. I want to show you what I mean, because I think it is hard to understand what I'm trying to explain. This is my arm. Thank you for your attention. In this scenario, my arm represents 47 in its normal state. The camera is exactly on my shoulder, and it only moves when my arm moves. Now, my arm is moving towards the wall. When my hand is touching the wall, my arm and the wall collide. The camera can't go any further from now on because my arm is not able to move further. It can move around, but that doesn't change how far my arm can go towards the wall. In scenario 2, my arm represents 47 in its aiming state. The camera still is on the exact same position. What changed, you ask? My arm is shrinking now. So, what have I done? You see, the arm you see here isn't real. It is pre-recorded. I took my arm, positioned my camera on my shoulder, and filmed my arm in front of a green screen. Now I filmed everything that relates to the wall, including the movement with my other arm. In the last part, I put both videos in my editor, removed the green screen, and put the other video on the other layer below it. Now it looks like my arm is next to the wall, when in fact it never was. The result is that my arm, if the recording of the wall allows it, can move as close to the wall as the camera can, which can make the wall look bigger than it actually is, but also prevents me from clipping through it, since my arm is unable to reach the wall because it never was near it. Nearly every first-person game uses this trick from CSGO to Minecraft. The reason why this seems weird and this doesn't lays in the difference between perspective and model. Let's take CSGO for example. In the first-person view, your weapon, no matter how long it is, can't reach the wall. In the third-person view, however, you see, it can't be further from reality. Anyway, both perspectives seem right to us. This perspective isn't bugged out, and this perspective seems realistic. So, why is it different in Hitman Absolution? Well, it's simple actually. The model of 47 is, in both states, in the common one and in the aiming one, seen from a third person. The perspective attached to this kind of model, however, changes. This perspective is common for a third person view, and this perspective is common for a first person view. This, however, is a first person perspective for a third person view, which is why it looks completely unfitting. Now, I don't know if there's any kind of use in this little fun fact, but I still think it is worth knowing. Also, thanks to Minus Report for helping me with the CSGO pictures. Love you.